intense. Boris and Macron were at each other's throats over deals regarding recent phishing attack. Boris Johnson this afternoon vowed to stand by Jersey as he attacked Emmanuel Macron for issuing menacing threats in a post-Brexit phishing row. The Prime Minister met with Jersey Chief Minister, Senator John Lafondre and the island's Minister for External Relations to discuss the recent escalation in rhetoric from Paris. Mr. Macron's government had demanded Britain and the Channel Islands issue more fishing licenses for French vessels to operate in UK waters or face retaliation. They warned they would be willing to cause disruption to shipments from the continent and even cut off electricity supplies unless their demands were met. Mr. Johnson this afternoon renewed his support to protect Jersey from any fallout over the fishing row. A UK government spokesman said, the Prime Minister met with Jersey Chief Minister, Senator John Lafondre, and the Minister for External Relations, Senator Ian Gorst, earlier today. He underlined the strength of the UK-Jersey relationship and committed to continue working closely together on issues of mutual importance. On fishing licenses, the Prime Minister reaffirmed his support for Jersey's approach, which has been reasonable and fully in line with the Trade and Cooperation Agreement, TCA. He noted that both the UK and Jersey were issuing licenses on basis of evidence of historic fishing activity, as required by the TCA. Under the terms of the Brexit trade deal struck last December, fisheries which can prove they have access to UK waters for at least one day a year for 4 years must be granted licenses giving them permission to continue to do so. Officials in London say all those who have provided the necessary evidence have been given permits. Mr. Johnson told Jersey the actions of the French government were unjustified as he warned any action taken by Paris to follow through on their threats would break international law. The spokesman added, the Prime Minister said that France's recent threats were unjustified and would have breached the TCA. He reiterated that the UK would continue to stand behind Jersey in the event that they were carried through, although he welcomed their deferral and said he hoped that they would be taken off the table permanently. Both sides agreed that they would continue to assess new evidence in support of the remaining license applications and that technical discussions with the EU Commission and France would continue. Mr. Macron appeared to backtrack on his threats 2 weeks ago when he announced he was suspending the implementation of retaliatory measures to allow for talks to continue. As the fishing row with France erupts, the Prime Minister has been warned that current fisheries legislation do not go far enough. Oceana, an NGO established for ocean conservation, told The Express that there was no strong evidence that the UK fisheries were becoming more sustainable, and called on the government to do more to end overfishing with its post-Brexit powers. The International Conservation Organization said, Brexit provides an opportunity to break the status quo. The UK could use its additional powers over shared stocks since Brexit to create a step change, to end overfishing, and we call on them to do so, but we see no sign of that yet. Meanwhile, some conservation objectives in the main piece of legislation passed by the government concerning the UK fishing industry, the Fisheries Act 2020, were not ambitious enough and are even one step behind the EU Common Fisheries Policy. One such policy was the EU's commitment to recover and maintain fish stocks above maximum sustainable yield level. Oceana did, however, praise the Act for setting objectives that are totally absent in EU legislation, such as the climate change objective. Since leaving the EU, the UK has been able to set its own sustainable fishing targets. In 2020, Parliament passed the Fisheries Act, which called for fishing to be environmentally sustainable in the long term and such that fleets are economically viable but do not overexploit marine stocks. It also required that fishing activities are managed using an ecosystem-based approach so as to ensure that their negative impacts on marine ecosystems are minimized and, where possible, reversed, and incidental catches of sensitive species are minimized and, where possible, eliminated. The law also calls for UK fishing activities to adapt to climate change. When the UK left the EU, it was no longer bound by the EU's objective on maintaining fish stocks. Oceana noted in an audit earlier this year that there are concerns that the sustainability objectives are more flexible than those required by the EU. To its credit, the UK government had been able to convince the EU to set catch limits on several fish stocks, including Norway pout and sand eel, which Oceana described as a step in the right direction. These species are key for the marine ecosystem as they are the prey of other commercial fish species and marine wildlife such as seabirds and marine mammals.